My name is Dawn Deacon, thoracic oncology nurse navigator for Sarah Cannon at Centerpoint. Please welcome Dr. Prem Samuel, our cardiothoracic surgeon here at Centerpoint. He's going to talk to us about lung cancer, signs, symptoms, and what to do if you suspect you may have lung cancer. What is a cardiothoracic surgeon?
A cardiothoracic surgeon is someone who operates in the chest. I have this privilege to render this care to our patients, someone who does surgery of the heart, the aorta, all the big blood vessels, including the lungs. And that's what a cardiothoracic surgeon does.
Lung cancer is the leading cause of death among men and women every year. What factors contribute to the poor outcomes?
Great question. Lung cancer has been a nemesis for all our patients for a long period of time. And there's no question that smoking is one of the most important causes for lung cancer. And the sad part about lung cancer is oftentimes patients have no symptoms at all. And they go by leading their normal lives, or at least they assume that they have a normal life. And then they go for a test for some other reason, and then they're diagnosed with lung cancer. So by the time you expect the patient to have symptoms, it's too far gone.
For years, patients, especially smokers, will get a chest x-ray with their yearly physical. Over the last several years, there's been a change in this practice. Why?
You know, for the longest time, we were told that you got to get a chest x-ray. I never believed that the chest x-ray was going to pick up problems. And I thought, because the sensitivity of a chest x-ray was so low, I always thought a low-dose CT was the answer. And now they revised the guidelines, and anyone who has the high index of suspicion for cancer, low-dose CT scan is the way to go, because that can pick up lesions which are oftentimes missed by a chest x-ray.
Dr. Samuel, what are the advantages of CT lung screenings?
The goal of CT lung screening is to pick up lesions which are oftentimes missed by x-rays. It can pick up small lesions, and then we look at the type of lesions, and then we decide where do we go from here. If there is a high index of suspicion based on the appearance and also based on the history of smoking, then we go after it. We have new technology out here. We have a navigational bronch. We have an ion bronchoscope, which is actually the first one in the state of Missouri. We have endobronchial ultrasound. So we have all the gadgets we can to get to diagnosis. And then on top of that, we also have a CT-guided biopsy as well. So we have a wide range of tests in which we can try to get a diagnosis for any spots in the lung anywhere.
If you're interested in a CT lung screening, please contact your PCP. To be eligible, you must be between the ages of 55 and 77 years old, are currently a smoker or have quit within the last 15 years, and have at least a 30-pack per year history of smoking with no signs or symptoms of lung cancer. You have been diagnosed with lung cancer. What's next?
Well, my first thing is, it's not the end of the world. I know the diagnosis of cancer is bad and it looms large over, but if you have a diagnosis of lung cancer, we have multiple people at different levels who can help you through the process. We have a cancer navigator, we have a well-organized team, we have surgeons, we have oncologists, we have radiation oncologists and radiologists and pathologists, and we have a team approach to this problem. We put all our heads together, we meet once or twice a month, we talk about every patient, and we come up with a strategy of how best to treat our patients.
What are the benefits of robotic-assisted surgery?
You know, Dawn, it's a great question, and robotic surgery, especially for lung cancer, in my opinion, it's been a game changer. I've been doing this practice for about 20 years, and I see a clear difference in how our patients do with robotic thoracic surgery. The 17 years of my practice, we used to open chest, and we used to take part of the lung, or in fact the whole lung out, but pain is such a big factor with these patients. But robotic thoracic surgery has been a game changer. The number of patients who have pain is less, the duration of surgery is shorter, the recovery is faster, and the dependency on narcotics is also minimized. We owe this to our patients and society in general, because with the opioid pandemic, we need to contribute. And I believe thoracic surgery with the robot is clearly a winner.
Dr. Samuel, can you tell me a little bit about the surgical robot?
So this is our robot. It's got four arms. It's a massive, highly advanced computer. And so these arms are attached to our instruments, which are then placed through small incisions on the patient. And so we have a wide range of movement for all these four arms. And with a use of a toggle, I can switch my arms around. By being a surgeon, I have two hands. So here, potentially, I have three hands. I can switch forth. I can have two left hands or two right hands, or given the scenario, I can flip back and forth. So that's our robot. I operate in this console through these arms on the patient. And this magnification is about 10 times more. It's three-dimensional. It has four arms. And as I said before, the blood loss is minimal. The recovery is faster. The pain is so small. And overall, I think this is one of the best things which have happened for our patients.
Thank you for joining us today. For more information regarding lung cancer and the other services available here at CenterPoint Medical Center, please visit www.centerpointmedical.com.